Hello guys, today I will show you guys how to do my Mardin pool for Ghost Mushroom, Elemental Earth, and Solid Stone. As you can see, I entered through purple side. To get the Ghost Mushrooms, of course, we start here. Now there's two major requirements for this farm. The first one is having Blade of Eternal Darkness. It's such a good item, guys. Just get it. It's amazing. Even for raiding, it's just perfect. I wear it in AQ all the time. It's absolutely great. The other requirement is Herbalism. You don't need Herbalism, I'd say. If you don't have Herbalism, you probably want to enter through Crew Prince's side. So you don't waste your time walking through purple. To enter Prince's side, you need the Scepter of Celebrus. You can get that from a quest. You have to kill Princess and like two other bosses here in Mardin. Ooh. Okay, guess I can pass that. A little bit of a mistake. you can also do it without the Blade of Eternal Darkness, but I really don't recommend it. Because you'll run out of mana. There's probably other ways. You can kite all the mobs using Cone of Cold and using the 5 second rule. Maybe you can do it using Blizzard. I don't know. Something like that, but the blade just makes it so much more clean. And it's also a lot of fun. But either way, I suggest you should get the blade first. I'm thinking of making a video about how I farm the blade. Basically, how I will do it is I will enter through the same side here. I will enter on purple side, get all the ghost mushrooms, and then kill Princess. The reason I don't do the same farm and kill Princess is because if you're farming the dagger, you really want to do 5 runs an hour, and you really can make it any other way. And if you take all these mushrooms, you can exactly do this farm in like 9 minutes, with Princess included. And you have 2 minutes to reset. So quickly, why would you do this farm? Because, you know, mages have the ability to boost, which is obviously a lot of gold. First of all, if you're a hardcore PvPer, unlike me, but if you love doing hardcore PvP, especially when it's AV weekend, you can queue AV and actually do this farm in the meanwhile. You can do that when you're boosting Scarlet Monastery or any other place. You can't queue AV that way. Well, I don't know, maybe you can, but I mean, you have to leave the group then, and it takes a while to find people to boost, so it's a little annoying. You don't want to be doing that. You can queue it, you know, it can pop at any time, and here you always have the ability to leave. The other big reason is it's actually pretty good. It's, you know, I can't really say how much gold you get per hour. I should say my blink actually. But I'd say it's at least 70 gold. Today, I got like 150 gold an hour doing it. So it really depends, guys. Like, all the mobs you're killing, they can drop Edgemasters as well, which obviously, you know, it's a big lottery item, and I wouldn't depend on Edgemasters, but if it drops, it's nice. Of course it is. It's like between 4 or 5k gold or something. It's great. We don't go all the way into orange side, by the way. We just want to get this one. Oh. That's probably as far as we go. Let's look at my talents quickly. Yeah, this is a very general talent build I use. Normally I also take Ice Shards for the Shatter damage. It's not really necessary. I actually forgot to pick it, I'll be honest. I will probably not pick these four talents and cut one in that and then take Ice Shards. For this farm, obviously you don't need a magic absorption. But I like to take it anyway. If I decide to boost Scarlet Monastery, I can do it. Or Maridon. Because I do a lot of different farms, like boosting Scarlet Monastery, CG, that kind of stuff, you know. Oh, and if you don't have the dagger, the Blade of Eternal Darkness, you probably want to be taking Arcane Concentration and Meditation for that extra mana effectiveness. You don't have the same mana pool, like infinite mana pool I have with the dagger, so you gotta be a little bit conservative on mana, and that helps out a lot, especially when you're doing Cone of Cold kiting and using the 5-second rule and whatnot. And especially Arcane Concentration, because how the 5-second rule works is that you start regenerating mana basically if you haven't spent mana. That's important, that spending mana part in 5 seconds. So, like, for example, if on a Warlock you life tap, that's a spell you cast, but it doesn't interrupt your mana regen. And the same counts for if you get the proc on Arcane Concentration, so it gives even more mana than you think, which is pretty good. Oh, usually I'm gonna use it now. I always use this, I actually forgot to use it. Makes a lot faster, so probably I would be like a minute faster. A minute? 1/5. Yeah, a minute faster. About a minute faster. This petrol's all the way up, so we got enough time. If it's right about there, where that guy is, we have to be quick, because these guys can actually chain pull the behemoths. You don't want that to happen. Alright, let's just dance around this guy. You probably don't want to be doing what I did. Getting close to these guys that can stun you, but I guess I was a little bit lucky. If you get stunned, obviously you can blink, but I did use my blink there, so. Looking at gear. Sorry about that. Don't trip myself. I wanted to get this blind weed. Yeah, looking at my gear is not really optimal for this at all. You want a lot of intellect, like these items, for example, they're not really that good. I think spell power isn't that great. I think 1% crit is about 1% crit is about 22 spell power. So this is worth like about 2% crit. I mean, that's not bad, but it doesn't give any intellect. And so, you know, I didn't optimize for this farm, but because I don't really need intellect, so that's why I actually like it a little bit. You know, just a bit, little bit of extra stamina is great. Yeah, that's not nice. Yeah, that was not good. I got hit and the mobs in the group that well, because I did this. Usually I find a way to actually get that blind weed there while I'm pulling, but I decide not to bother. I decided to walk that way. I don't always do that. I just wanted the mobs to be grouped a little bit more because I fucked up a little. So. See, they group pretty decently, let's say. I also don't have any bandages and I took some damage, so. Usually when I take bandages, it's actually really good. It's actually pretty important, I'd say, to have bandages with you for this farm. Alright, it's like I hit to walk this way. Now pull that. See, that falling damage, it's hard to avoid. You could time blink that you don't take damage when you do it. I don't have bandages with me, so I just gotta be a little bit more careful. See, I just got 400 mana. Frost Nova cost 50 mana, so. I mean, you're just chugging mana potions by using rank 1 spells, which is fucking, it's absolutely crazy. It is just so good. Alright, let's just shield up. And what I do, I like to blink. So the mobs are grouped a little bit better. You'll see me, you see 900 mana. It's absolutely crazy, guys. And you can use a lot of rank 1 spells here. It will actually make you make everything a little bit more mana intensive, mana effective. But I'm full mana, so I don't need to be that conservative with my mana. I mean, this is kind of an important part here. I mean, it's not that bad. You just want them to die at the same time, really. So I'm just using rank 1 spells and trying to get them low at the same time. Something like this. This is a little bit overkill what I'm doing here. See, they all got out the same way, at the same time. I'm a little bit low on mana, so I'm just gonna use rank 1 spells. Oh. If that happens, just blink away and undo this. Now, there we go. Now you see how much elemental earth I can get. And again, guys, it's a very nice, effective farm. It's not that hard. You can just chill, watch your movies in the meanwhile, you know. talk with your friends, do whatever you want. It's probably good to have like an add-on that, makes this looting a little bit quicker, so like add-on makes you auto loot all the time and the window doesn't pop up. There are some scripts for that, I think. There is ways to make this faster. And I suggest doing that because this is very tedious to, keep clicking like this, but you know, it is what it is. But this is the first video I made. I made this video like, I might post it on YouTube, and this will probably be like the first video I've ever posted or made in my entire life, so you know. If you liked it, please like, you know, drop a follow or subscribe on YouTube, or you can find me on twitch.tv/AmberAlice. It's my Warlock's name there at the left. I'll probably post it as well. And yeah, I mean, I post this kind of content a lot. Do this kind of content. Jesus Christ, I'm so unlucky. Are you kidding me? I got no elemental earth. So guys, that never happens usually, but that's like the RNG part. You can get no elemental earth. I think I got 7. No, I got 9 one time actually. Like, you can get a lot. You can get like, sometimes you get nothing. Actually, that never happens. Oh, I got 1 there. Nice. That's 1 at least, you know. Oh, I got 2. I mean, 2 is nothing to be happy about, but oh. Well, guys, I really appreciate you guys watching. I'll probably make a video about the princess farm. Then in the meanwhile, guys, just chill, you know. Do this farm. If you have any questions, you can hit me up on Discord. It's below my my Twitch. So I'll see you guys in the next one, and peace out, guys. Cheers.